Very pleasant morning to you all. I'm Dr. Anju Arya, IPAC Director and Dean R&D of Sri L.R. Tiwari College of Engineering. At the outset, I welcome you all on behalf of management of Rahul Education Society. Nowadays, most of the students are in dilemma about their career. They are not able to take the decision which field is better for their future. That's why Rahul Education Society has decided to take the initiative to guide the students or to show a right path to the students. Rahul Education Society always takes innovative steps to help the society. This time also, we have invited a great achiever and an eminent speaker, Honorable Dr. K.G. Narayan Thekar. Dr. K.G. Narayan Thekar is ex-director of DGTI, ex-chancellor of MGM Institute of Health Science, ex-professor and dean planning of IIT Bombay. I would like to introduce him in brief. He has done his postdoctoral research work at the Department of Engineering Science, Cryogenics Laboratory, University of Oxford, UK. He has completed his M.Tech and Ph.D. from IIT Bombay. Professor Narayan Thekar developed several technologies in the high-tech areas of cryogenics and successfully transferred these technologies in LPSC, Valadimala and Isaac Bangalore. Some of his landmark development in the area of cryogenics include Stirling cycle nitrogen liquefier and liquid nitrogen-based individual quick freezing tunnel. He is also actively involved in the review programs related to development of cryogenic engine in the Department of Space. Professor Narayan Thekar was honored with several prizes and awards. K.L. Garg Memorial Cash Medal Award and Scroll of Merit for outstanding piece of research work on cryo-refrigerators leading to development of prototypes in 1978, and the prestigious Dr. P.K. Patwardhan Award for the innovative technology development on the pulse tube cryo-cooler using the linear compressor on the occasion of the Teacher's Day celebration in 2004 at IIT Bombay. He was honored with the highest and the most prestigious national award, Professor A. Bose Memorial Lifetime Contribution Award in 2004, for his outstanding contribution to cryogenic engineering globally recognized. He was also honored by the Lions Club of Mumbai in recognition of generous and dedicated work in higher education. I welcome Dr. Narayan Thekar to enlighten the path of students with his thoughtful insight. Thank you, sir. Dr. Narayan Thekar, I welcome you.
Good morning to you all. It's a great pleasure to be with you this morning to share my experiences about career guidance. As we have assembled today for career in engineering, I'll confine myself for careers in engineering field. So let's have a look at some of the slides which we have prepared for this purpose, and let's see what messages we can pass on using these slides for choosing the right career in engineering. Let's start with a question. What is the importance of September 15? Just a couple of days back, we had September 15th. And I'm sure most of you are aware why we celebrate September 15. So let's look at it. This is a small video which will tell us about
आणि हे व्हिडिओ म्यूटच आहे पण आता हे चालू आहे. पण तुला
So we have seen the video which tells us two important messages. The first one is the railway, which carries passengers. Can you tell me who has made railways? Who are the architects behind making railways possible? The second message is regarding the great engineer that India is proud of, Dr. Vishwesharaiya. And this is a message to show how alert an engineer is and how can one check whether there is any problem just by listening to the vibrations. And this is what the qualities are expected in engineers. So we are very fortunate that we have recently celebrated Engineers Day in the memory of Sir M.V., which is popularly known for Sir Mokshagundam Vishwesharaiya. He was an alumnus of College of Engineering, Pune, and he has done marvels in civil engineering. So this is what is the role of engineer. And engineer has to do several activities. If you look around, whatever you see around is a creation by engineers. So engineer and creativity are synonymous. Engineers are known for creativity, creations are known for engineers. Every creativity which you see, maybe the table, chair, mobile phone, electrical bulb, electrical tubes, door phone and whatnot. Everything is due to engineers. In a common public, if you have bunch of engineers, you will not be able to recognize them as engineers. However, if there are doctors, if there are lawyers in the crowd, you can easily make out because of the stethoscope as well as the black uniform the lawyers use. But engineers very rarely use any uniform. So their recognition is only due to creativity and the creation they have made for the benefit of us. Now let's understand what is engineering. Engineering is a scientific field and job that solves taking our scientific understanding of the natural world and using it to invent, design, and build things to solve problems and achieve practical goals. So what the engineering is? Dealing with inventions, designs, and building things. What for? To solve problems and achieve practical goals. So there's always a goal with every activity which is associated with the engineering area. Now, engineering is a very vast field. Just some examples, if you see around the roads, the bridges, the cars, the planes, machines, tools, processes, computers, etc., is only due to engineers and engineering. It also covers skyscrapers, design of machinery, development of software, etc. Engineering is space exploration, virtual reality, and future technologies. So it covers everything which you see around. Engineering is the science, skill, and profession of acquiring and applying scientific, economic, social and practical knowledge in order to design and also build structures, machines, devices, systems, materials, and processes. You can see how vast the area is. To build structures, machines, devices, systems, materials, and processes. And what we are applying? Scientific, economic, social, and practical knowledge. And that's how we build these activities and devices. Engineering is knowledge that opens up opportunity in various technologies, products, which have made our life easier. Whatever we are having comfort today is because of these products and technologies which are made available to us due to engineering. The word engineering has its root in the word engine, which comes from Latin word ingenium. This is a Latin word, ingenium, which means innate quality, particularly of mental power. Innate quality of mental power. That means it is a mental ability of an engineer to come up with variety of products, variety of processes, and variety of activities which are going to be useful to the mankind. Engineering is not usually considered a science. Science is about discovering the natural phenomena. Engineering is creating the designed environment. Engineers apply the principles of science and mathematics to develop solutions to problems. This is very important and very particular where the principles of science and mathematics are used to develop solution to problems. And that's how engineers are known as problem solvers. Day to day, one faces several problems, and the ability of the engineer using the thinking capacity, vision, one can always come up with a solution to the problem. Some examples, once again, we can cite are the playgrounds, the buildings, the fence, a bike, helmet, cell phone, cooler, water bottles, sunglass, football, chair, sandals, watch, everything what you see around is all engineered. And that's how we are making use of all these facilities for our comfort. Now, let's ask ourselves why engineering is a great career. What makes it a great career? Engineers are creative thinkers. Engineers are problem solvers. They are the best communicators, team players. Engineers are some of the most sought after people for a diverse range of jobs. Because the skills which are developed can be used for solving the problems and coming up with the solutions for the activities. Engineer is a person who creates nifty and practical inventions. And there are several such inventions which you are aware about and you are using into day-to-day practice for your own comfort as well as utility. Why one should choose engineering profession? When we compare with several job opportunities, several professions which one can go for, in comparison, we can see that this is one of the best jobs because one can design one's own creations. Whatever imagination you have, you can adopt it and have certain creations which can be useful to the mankind. Having created such processes, products, one always looks for making it better, better, and better. And this is again a thinking process that how to make the product better. Better can be a relative term. It could be in terms of its look. It may be in terms of its weight. It may be in terms of its utility. It may be in terms of its energy consumption. So there are several factors which could be considered for making a creation better, better, and better. There are worldwide job opportunities. All kinds of businesses recognize engineers as people that are very well educated and good at solving problems. So this is the key. Key of the engineering is one should be able to solve problems. The problems which are encountered in the practical life will not be the problems which we see in the textbooks. Several things are not known. One has to imagine, one has to assume, and with those assumptions, one can move forward to come up with a solution to the problem. And thus, this particular skill of solving problems, and that to practical problems, is one of the attributes of engineering. Engineering is not a new concept. Concept of engineering existed since ancient times. And that's how they discovered pulley, lever, and wheel, which we are using even today. Pulley, lever, and wheel, these are the basic elements of engineering. And thus, we can see the ancient people were wise enough to use engineering principles to make their life better. Past, present, and future of engineering. In the past, there were only four major branches of engineering, namely mechanical engineering, chemical engineering, civil engineering, and electrical engineering. But today, we can see several branches of engineering which have emerged due to the needs, like electronics engineering, electronics and communication engineering, mechatronics. Also, there are several courses in computers, like computer science and engineering, computer engineering, information technology, and so on and so forth. There are also new engineering branches which are emerging now, like artificial intelligence, big data, data management, as a result of revolution, which is known as Revolution Industry 4.0. And thus, artificial intelligence is becoming one of the very important thrust areas which will take Industry 4.0 activities forward. Now let's take up these four major branches which have been there in the past and even now. First is mechanical engineering. An engineering branch that combines engineering physics and mathematics principles with material science to design, analyze, manufacture, and maintain mechanical systems. What we are doing here? Engineering physics. Physics is the root of engineering and mathematics principles, along with material science, that means materials, for the purpose of design, analysis, and manufacture, and also maintain mechanical systems. So this is the core job of a mechanical engineer. It is one of the oldest and broadest of the engineering branches. All mechanical engineers are sought after in the industries for a variety of activities, including design, analysis, manufacture on the shop floor, and even for the purpose of maintenance. Mechanical engineering, a typical mechanical engineer does the following activities: analyze problems to see how mechanical and thermal devices might help solve the problems. How mechanical and thermal devices might help solve the problems. Design or redesign mechanical and thermal devices using analysis and computer-aided design, which is popularly known as CAD, C-A-D. Develop and test prototypes and devices they design. You can see the steps one after one. Analyze the test results and change the design as needed. Oversee the manufacturing process for the device. So one can see you are coming with the analysis of the problem. Then you are having the design or redesign of a component, of a device. Then we are having a prototype which is developed and tested. And if the prototype doesn't satisfy the requirements, analyze the results, change the design so that it is suitable for a particular application. Having done this, final product is supervised while it is getting manufactured. So these are the typical roles of a mechanical engineer. The design is the most important component. The manufacturing is taken care of today by sophisticated machines, CNCs, and all computer-aided machines. Computer-aided manufacturing helps us to do a precision machining of various products. Under the mechanical engineering, you will find several specializations. I'm just mentioning a few of them, like mechatronics and robotics, micro electromechanical systems, MEMS, thermodynamics and thermosciences. These are some of the specializations one can go for in mechanical engineering. Next, we go for civil engineering. This is also one of the oldest branches of engineering. And as I have told, Sir M.V. was a civil engineer. A professional engineering discipline that deals with the design, construction, and maintenance of the physical and naturally built environment, including public works such as roads, bridges, canals, dams, airports, sewerage systems, pipelines, structural components of buildings and railways. These are some of the activities which civil engineers carry out. One can see it involves design. Design is a key feature everywhere. Design, construction, and maintenance of various products, various facilities which are provided by civil engineers. Civil engineers apply the principles of geotechnical engineering, structural engineering, environmental engineering, transportation engineering, and construction engineering to residential, commercial, industrial, and public works projects of all sizes and at all levels of construction. So you are aware of various activities which are going on, like construction of buildings, construction of dams, construction of roads. Now there is a massive program of constructing roads all over the country. And this is where the civil engineers play a very important role in making such facilities for the country. As I said, the railways is one of the transport devices for mass transport of people, and this is also due to engineers. There are several such activities which are done by civil engineers. Now let's come to electrical engineering. This is also one of the oldest branches. Electrical engineering is an engineering discipline concerned with the study, design, and application of equipment, devices, and systems which use electricity, electronics, and electromagnetism. All the devices which use electricity are essentially due to electrical engineers. Not only this, they are also responsible for generating electricity. There are different modes of generating electricity, and once electricity is generated, it is used for running various devices. Let's look at one of the oldest electrical supply. In 1882, Thomas Edison switched on the world's first large-scale electric power network that provided 110 volts direct current DC to several customers on Manhattan Island in New York City. So this is the start. And having started, you can see, today we cannot live without electricity. Even if electricity is off for a few minutes, you are uncomfortable because everything is running on electricity. And that's where the electrical engineers play a very vital role in terms of helping the human kind for the very comfort conditions and also utilizing various devices properly. The electrical engineering has several branches: power engineering, control engineering, signal processing, instrumentation, and mechatronics. Power engineering is dealing with the power generation. Control engineering is controls, various controls, variety of controls which are used in various engineering applications. Signal processing, instrumentation is one more key feature of electrical engineering. And finally, an interdisciplinary area of mechatronics. So these are the various specializations. There are many more, but I'm listing a few which will attract you why electrical engineering is important as a career. Now we come to the fourth branch, which is one of the oldest branches, and that's chemical engineering. Chemical engineering is a branch of engineering that uses principles of chemistry, physics, mathematics, biology, and economics to efficiently use, produce, transport, and transform energy and materials. See here, the knowledge of chemistry is one of the important areas. And you can see chemical industries all around. And one can also appreciate the products which are being made by chemical engineers. Even the fuel which we use for domestic purposes, for vehicles, is also due to chemical engineering. So chemical engineering is one of the oldest and evergreen branch of engineering. Chemical engineers are involved in many aspects of plant design and operation, including safety and hazard assessment, process design and analysis, modeling, controlled engineering, chemical reaction engineering, nuclear engineering, biological engineering, construction specification, and operating instructions. So these are the variety of roles chemical engineers play. Particularly, if you look at the safety and hazard. So this is one of the major issues, that what type of safety devices are used to take care of the hazards. And also, when you look at the control engineering, once again, there are several controls which are introduced in any chemical engineering plant so that the plant operates properly and safely. And thus, these are the variety of roles a chemical engineer plays in the practical life. Now we come to some of the newer areas. They are no more new. They are introduced about 30 years back. Electronics engineering. Electronics engineering, also called as electronics and communications engineering, utilizes non-linear and active electrical components such as semiconductor devices to design electronic circuits, devices, integrated circuits, and their systems. What are included? Semiconductor devices, electronic circuits, devices, integrated circuits, and their systems. The discipline typically also designs passive electrical components, particularly PCBs, that is printed circuit boards. And that's how one can see how one can put all the components in a small board. Engineers also deal with mobile networks and internet as communications. So these are the variety of activities which are done by electronics engineers. Now we come to computer engineering. Computer engineering is a branch of engineering that integrates several fields of computer science and electronic engineering required to develop computer hardware and software. Computer hardware and software. One can see the revolution which is going on in computers. It started maybe 3 to 4 decades back, and today what we see is a phenomenon. What type of miniaturization has been done, what type of efficiencies have been introduced in the system, and how they have made the entire device a very compact device. And that's all due to engineering efforts and research. Computer engineers are involved in many hardware and software aspects of computing, from the design of individual components like microcontrollers, microprocessors, personal computers, supercomputers, to circuit design. There are several activities which are covered under computer engineering. Microcontrollers for control purposes, microprocessors, personal computers, supercomputers, and circuit design. Computer engineering is also covering the robotics research. Robotics is now taking over, and that is one of the activities under Industry 4.0 revolution. And thus, computer engineers are suited for robotics research, which relies heavily on digital systems to control and monitor electrical systems like motors, communications, and sensors. Robotics has all these three: motors, communications, and sensors. They are all controlled so that the robotics can be useful for various activities as desired by the customers. Now we come to information technology. Information Technology Association of America has defined information technology as the study, design, development, application, implementation, and support or management of computer-based information systems. So in fact, if you look at the information technology, it essentially deals with database, data retrieval, data transmission, data manipulation, and application software. The responsibilities of those working in the field include network administration, software development and installation, and the planning of management of an organization's technology life cycle, by which hardware and software are maintained, upgraded, and replaced. Information technology essentially addresses the business operations so that whatever information required can be easily retrieved for the purpose of business. Information technology is study, design, development, implementation, support, or management of computer-based information systems, particularly software applications and computer hardware. So it is the management of the information, how information can be retrieved, how can it be utilized, how it can be stored. This is all due to information technology, and we are witnessing it because of IT. Today we can get any information just by clicking just mouse. You get variety of information, and that is all possible because of IT. One can see the role of information technology. First is the computer hardware, database, internet, security, software design, applications, network, servers, support, and communication. It covers a whole bunch of activities, and that's how information technology is one of the most sought after branch of engineering. Now, having seen so many branches of engineering, we can also know that there are some more branches which are being offered in several engineering institutes. And one of them is engineering physics as a branch of engineering, because physics is the root of engineering. So engineering physics is a versatile branch of engineering. It is essentially offered in IITs. In addition to this, there are some specialized branches like agricultural engineering, which is also offered by very select institutes, mining engineering, so that the engineers can work on the mines, and also metallurgical engineering. So these are certain areas which are also required for the progress of engineering. So with the combination of all these engineering activities and using the mental capacity, thinking capacity, problem solving capacity, the engineers have made best engineering marvels. And there is a list given here, which covers a few of them. CN Tower in Canada, Empire State Building in New York, Golden Gate Bridge in California, Panama Canal in Panama, Itapu Dam in Brazil, the Channel Tunnel, Delta and Judry's Works, the Falkirk Wheel, Palm Islands in Dubai, Three Gorge Dam, Large Hadron Collider, Chandra X-ray Space Telescope, Shasta Dam, Millau Viaduct, Hubble Space Telescope, Hong Kong International Airport, ISS, Burj Khalifa in Dubai, and also, you know, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel statue in India, cryogenic engines development in India. These are all marvels of best engineering. Why it is possible? Because of the training the engineers receive for conceiving the ideas, pursuing the ideas, and realizing their dreams coming true as a process or as a product. Now let's look at some of these marvels. CN Tower in Canada, tallest freestanding structure in the world. Lightning strikes the CN Tower an average of 70 times per year. Long copper strips run down the CN Tower to ground so that there is no damage to the tower. Empire State Building in New York, tallest structure in the world, tallest freestanding structure in the world since 1967, tallest building in the world. The Empire State Building took 1 year and 45 days to build. More than 7 million man hours are used. Golden Gate Bridge, California, the longest suspension bridge in the world till 1964. It took 4 years to build. Panama Canal. On the average, it takes a ship 8 to 10 hours to pass through the canal. While moving through it, a system of locks raises each ship by about 28 meters above the sea level. Itapu Dam in Brazil, the largest operating hydroelectric facility in the world in terms of annual energy generation. This device produces the same amount of energy as burning 434,000 barrels of oil every day. Channel Tunnel, UK, the longest undersea portion of any tunnel in the world. An average of 60,000 passengers pass through the tunnel, along with 4,600 trucks, 140 coaches, and 7,300 cars. Delta and Burgi Works, Netherlands, the largest hydraulic engineering project undertaken by the Netherlands during 20th century. The Delta work took almost 50 years to complete. Official opening was on 2010. So these marvels give us what sort of engineering has gone into in building these world-renowned architectures and the devices, the facilities for us. And thus, if one has an aptitude, one has an inclination, one can also come up with such marvels by their own contributions. So see, the scope is infinite. It is up to us how we can use our skills for betterment of human life. Now let's look at some engineering challenges. There is a tower shown here. I think most of you may recognize it, what it is. It is one of the famous towers in Dubai. Burj Khalifa. It is a skyscraper, 829.8 meters high, tallest structure and building in the world. It has 4,000 tons of structural steel, and it has taken 45,000 cubic meters of concrete. Now you can imagine, in a tower like this, which is 829.8 meters high, how do you pour concrete? And that too, in a climate where the temperature is around 50 degrees centigrade. Concrete will settle very fast. And if it, due to the temperature, and if settles fast, it will lead to cracks. And that was a major engineering challenge while construction of Burj Khalifa. And that is a challenge which is taken by the engineers who have built this tower. How to face? Creating to withstand the concrete to the Gulf temperatures of 50 degrees centigrade. Any significant crank could have put the entire project in jeopardy. All efforts would have gone if there is a smallest crack. What is the solution? Of course, since we are able to see this tower standing there, there was a solution. And that came from engineering minds. And what is the solution? Pouring iced liquid concrete in the night. Avoid the day work. Day temperatures are very high. In the night, air is cooler and humidity is higher. So one can make use of this natural phenomena. Cool the concrete with ice and then pump it in the tower. And that's how this entire tower was successfully built. And today it has become one of the attractions for all the travelers from all over the world. Those who visit Dubai will never miss this tower. Cooler concrete cures more evenly and is therefore less likely to set too quickly and crack. And that is the advantage which is taken because of ice-cooled concrete. And this is the solution to the problem. And these solutions will never come across any textbooks. These are the field problems, and these have to be attended at the field by applying the knowledge of science and mathematics and also the common sense. And the next challenge we'll take up, that is the space applications. Space applications, which involves design and development of cryogenic engines. You must have already heard about Chandrayaan, Mangal mission, etc. And you must have seen how challenging these jobs are. And who is addressing these problems? The space scientists, the space engineers, were working for these projects. Cryogenic engine was a big dream for India. No country was willing to transfer this technology to India. And thus, the Indian scientists had to develop this technology themselves. And thus, cryogenic engine is completely indigenous technology. Indigenous cryogenic engine and stage. A cryogenic rocket stage is more efficient and provides more thrust for every kilogram of propellant it burns compared to solid and earth storable liquid propellant rocket engines. So that means if you want to go for such missions, there is no escape. One has to necessarily have cryogenic rocket stage. This has the challenges. One uses hydrogen as the fuel, oxygen as the oxidizer. This is natural. But now the question is, should one use hydrogen and oxygen in the form of gas or liquid? If we have to use in the gaseous form, you can see the enormous volume one has to carry, because the gases are very light, specific volume, and thus it will occupy large volume. Alternative is to compress and take them in heavy cylinders that adds to the mass. Then what is left out is to liquefy, because liquid occupies less volume, almost 700 times less compared to gas. So one would like to carry this fuel and oxidizer, that is hydrogen and oxygen, in the liquid state and use it as fuel and oxidizer. Oxygen liquefies at minus 183 degrees centigrade and hydrogenide minus 253 degrees centigrade. See the temperatures. And at these temperatures, if you have to carry this, it gives a big challenge of insulation, so that the liquid should not evaporate and it should be available whenever the rocket needs. It also includes a combustion chamber, fuel injector, fuel and oxidizer turbo pumps, cryogenic walls, regulators, fuel tanks, and rocket engine nozzles. The most important of these is fuel and oxidizer turbo pumps, which run at a very high speed. And that's a technology one has to develop so that these pumps operate in thousands of revolutions per minute. Now, the Department of Space is in a position to develop such engines with a nominal thrust of 196.5 kilonewtons in vacuum and a specific impulse of 434 seconds. Such areas which are crucial, there is no alternative but to develop these technologies in-house. And that is what the India could show, that we are capable of developing such high-tech areas and succeed. Now coming to the education, having seen all these marvels, engineering challenges, are our engineering colleges geared to adopt and produce the engineers who can cope up with these challenges? And thus, AICTE and NBA, All India Council of Technical Education, National Board of Accreditation, they have introduced what is known as outcome-based education. And it is mandatory to all the colleges to follow outcome-based education. One may wonder, what is so great about outcome-based education? What was wrong with the previous system? Previous system was essentially based on inputs. The professors teach. Their job is done. Whether the students have understood or not is seen only in the examinations. Whereas outcome-based education aims at the outcomes which are necessary for a graduate. There could be a variety of outcomes. Even you take one lecture and find out what is the outcome of that lecture. You teach a course and find out what is the outcome of that course. That is known as course outcome. And a program like engineering, a student studies for 4 years, and what is the outcome of that program after 4 years? So this is very important change in the education system of engineering by introduction of outcome-based education. Here, the stress is on what the students learn rather than what the teachers teach. It is student learning, student-centric, learning-centric approach. And thus, at the end of 4 years, when the students have undergone about 40 courses, the sum total of all these outcomes should reflect in terms of final outcome. Outcome-based education aims at knowledge, skills, and attitude. Very important features: knowledge, technical knowledge, skills, thinking skills, application skills, presence of mind, attitudes. The graduate engineer will be able to demonstrate as having acquired on successful completion of a 4-year program of study. So knowledge, skills, and attitude, which are very, very vital for any engineering project. There are 12 program outcomes defined. I'm just mentioning so that one can see what is the stress and focus of engineering education today. One is interested in engineering knowledge, whether the knowledge is acquired by the students, whether the student can do problem analysis, whether one can come up with design and development of solutions, whether one can conduct investigations of complex problems. Not simple problem, complex problems which come in day-to-day life or practical problems. Modern tool usage. There are a variety of packages which are available today for the students to use, and that is what the scope is, that the students are exposed to all such modern tools which are used in the industry. Now, these are certain program outcomes which need special attention. The engineer and society. That means the engineer should be society sensitive. One should be able to address society problems so that the engineering reaches right up to the society root levels. Environment and sustainability, very important topic today. Ethics, whether we are using all ethical practices for design and development of engineering activities. Individual and teamwork. Engineering is not an individual work. It is a teamwork. Not only teamwork, but it is an interdisciplinary work. Communication. One should be able to communicate and tell about the engineering activities, engineering products, engineering processes, to the users and customers. Project management and finance. Everything runs as a management of a project. And what kind of management is required? What kind of finance is required for executing a project? And finally, lifelong learning. These are the 12 graduate attributes, which is now mandatory for all the colleges to focus and see that in 4 years, when the graduates come out of the college, they acquire all these attributes. Attainment of these program outcomes gives a focus on teaching and learning. So there is now a focus that we are now addressing these 12 attributes, which are accepted not only in India, but all over the world. And thus, if this is the focus, success of a professional is definitely assured, because a professional comes out of a college with these 12 attributes, is sensitive to all these 12 attributes, and thus there is a great success for the profession. I'll just give an example of teamwork and interdisciplinary approach in engineering. Let's take the example of a plane, and it is applicable for all the devices. If you look at the plane, can we say that it is a mechanical engineering, it is electrical engineering, electronics engineering, chemical engineering, or is it computer engineering? It is none of them. It is a combination of all. So it is interdisciplinary activity. Mechanical engineer is responsible for engine design. Mechatronics engineering deals with design of control systems. Mining engineer, fuel extraction. Chemical engineer, refining of the fuel. Electrical and software engineers are responsible for navigation. Whole team of engineers are responsible for making this product. So it is not only teamwork, but it is an interdisciplinary teamwork. Perfect coordination should take place between all types of engineers, right from mechanical engineers to electrical and software engineers. Then only a product sees the light of the day. Now, having seen this, what a great engineer should have. A great engineer has sharp problem-solving skills. An engineer is frequently called upon solely to address problems, and they must be able to figure out where the problem stems from and quickly develop a solution. So good problem-solving skills is very, very important for a graduate. Lifelong learning. A great engineer stays on top of the developments in the industry. Changes in technology happen rapidly. We are witnessing it. And the most successful engineers keep abreast of new research and ideas. So this is one more skill, to abreast ourselves with the new developments, new research, new technologies is mandatory for all engineers. Now let me ask you, do you want to design, develop, create, and innovate? Do you have some ideas which can be converted into design, develop, create, and innovate? Do you want to solve real life problems? Do you want to be creative? Do you want to turn ideas into reality? Do you want to help people and make their lives better? Do you want to become part of the world's most important profession? If your answer to these questions is yes, then you are the right person to follow this profession. Engineering is cities of the past and world of future. Engineering is nothing but imagineering. Imagine something and develop. It is ingenious. If you are convinced about this profession, 5 ticks, excellent. Welcome to this great and exciting career of engineering. Let me now. This is a shloka from Bhagavad Gita. It says, those whose faith is deep and who have practiced controlling their mind and senses attain divine knowledge. Through such transcendental knowledge, they quickly attain everlasting supreme peace. All the best. Shubham Bhavatu.
Thank you, sir. On behalf of Rahul Education Society, a heartfelt thank to Honorable Dr. K.G. Narayan Khekar to enlighten our students with his valuable insight. Thank you very much. If you have any query, you can mail to the query you can mail. We will reply through the mail only. So before we wind up the session, I would like to introduce Sri L.R. Tiwari College of Engineering. Honorable Chairman Sri Lalan Tiwari ji, the award received by Rahul Education Society, Eminent Educationist by Indus Foundation in 2013, third best institution in India in national contest on corporate employability for B schools and engineering institute by the HR Club in 2014, Education Excellence Award as a most promising upcoming private engineering college by Brand Academy in 2014, Award of Veteran in Education by Times Power Men West in 2018. We are offering 6 undergraduate program and 2 postgraduate program. We have mechanical engineering, civil engineering, electronic and telecommunication, electronics and computer science, computer engineering, and information technology. We have post-graduation in electronic and telecommunication engineering and computer engineering. We have well-established research and development cell. We have e-Yantra lab set up in collaboration with MHRD and IIT Bombay. Our student can do research and project work in the lab. This year, 10 research projects, minor research project has been sanctioned by Mumbai University. We have collaboration with CDAC for research project. For internship and other project collaborations, we have ESOCAM, GIST, NMEICT. This is for remote center. Our college is remote center for IIT Bombay. All the programs are running through remote. SIMCON, Student Alliance for research work and patents, Data Gemi for 3D printer, eSmart, Pratibha, and InfoVision for internship. Our institute is a nodal center for virtual lab in collaboration with College of Engineering. We have incubation center. Incubation center has collaboration with many industries for startups. They are supporting our startups in the college. These are the startups, Radius and Style, Silly Fox Software and Gaming Development Company. These are the startups of our students. One of the students, Abdullah, has been placed in Google with a package of 1.2 crore. We have well-developed play training and placement cell. These are our major recruiters. Some of the recruiters are Infosys, Seclor, Reliance, GS Learning, Byjus, and many more. These are also our major recruiters. We are conducting job fair every year. Last year, around 2,300 candidates witnessed job fair, and 197 colleges participated. 60 companies had offered job. This is year-wise placement report of Sri L.R. Tiwari College of Engineering. Every year, the placement is increasing. This year, our placement is 85% and through campus drive. And rest of the students are engaged in post-graduation program or entrepreneurship. They have their own startups. Year-wise number of companies, these many companies are coming to our college to conduct interviews. Through this placement drive, our students get placed. These are our distinguished alumni. Ritesh Shetty, he has been elected as Mr. India. He had Ashish Singh, he has cracked SSB interview. During in the training and placement and other courses we are running, we are providing training to the students. We are preparing them from competitions also, like GATE exam, like UPSC exam. We are providing them coaching. Along with the courses, they are getting all these expertise. He is appointed as assistant manager, Shubhajit Biswas. Karthik Raja, not only in academics, our students are very much active in co-curricular activities like sports, cultural, etc. We have number of chapters in our college, CSI, CESA for civil engineering, MESA for mechanical, IET for EXTC and electronics and computer science, and IST, we have institute membership. Under these programs, many activities for skill developments are organized. These are many extracurricular activities in our college. We are organizing Utsav Cultural Fest, Technical Fest, Business Sports, Engineers Day, Teachers Day, Farewell Party, Freshers Party, and Gava Celebration. Thank you very much. Sri L.R. Tiwari College of Engineering is a premier institute of Rahul Education Society. I'm thankful to you all from Rahul Education Society. Thank you very much. You can raise your query through the mail. You will definitely reply to me. Thank you.